Blender's built-in editor has some interesting features, like you can right-click almost any button and edit the source, and it has live editing, but it's also very buggy and it has a lot of quirks. Now, of course, you could use an external editor, but what's really missing is a proper debugger so you can set breakpoints and step through your code. Now, there are some editors that can remote debug Blender, and there's tutorials for those are out there already, but there aren't any for using VS Code to remote debug Blender. So I looked into that a bit, and I did find a Blender add-on that allows VS Code to remote debug it, but it didn't really have good documentation. So once I figured it out, I was just going to add some documentation, but I ended up rewriting the whole thing so that it's easier, especially if you're a beginner. It's really not that hard to set up, and I'll show you how to do that in this video. So first of all, if you don't have Python installed, you're going to want to install that. Go to python.org, downloads, and you need version 3. The other numbers don't really matter. So once you've downloaded that, I already have it on my desktop, install that. And when you install it, you're going to want to add Python to path. And in customize installation, pip should be checked. So pip will help us install the package we need. So I'm going to click next. Now, usually I would install for all users, but that would mean you have to use an admin command prompt. So that you don't have to do that, just leave everything as it is. Hit install. So once that's done, I'm just going to close it. And now in Windows, you can go to the little Windows icon, the start menu, right click, and open up a command prompt from there. And since I added Python to the path, now I can type in Python anywhere, hit enter, and Python should start up, and you should see the version we just downloaded. And I'm going to exit that. And you can also do where Python, or on Linux it's where is, and on Mac I think it's which. And that should return the paths of where it found Python. And for me, it returns two paths because I have Python installed and added to path somewhere else. But this is what the add-on uses to detect Python, and it'll use the first one that it returns. And now we can also do where pip, and same thing, pip is installed. And now with pip we can install ptvsd, which is the server that will run from Blender that VS Code will be able to connect to. And VS Code recommends version 3.0, so � 3.0.0. Hit enter, and that should install. And that's it for the command prompt. We can close that now. Now first, before we install my add-on, you're going to want to go into Blender. And if you loaded your script through the text editor and you registered it, or you installed it manually, you're going to want to go to User Preferences, Add-on, search for your add-on, and remove it. And then you're going to want to go to File, and right here there's a setting called Scripts. And what you want to do is you want to grab the folders for your add-ons, and just pick a folder somewhere. I have mine next to all my other code in a folder called Blender. And in here, you're going to want to create a folder called Add-ons. This part's very important. It has to be set up like this. And inside there, you can put your add-ons. So now we grab the path, this path, and you want to set it to scripts, and save your user settings. And when you restart Blender, if you go to your add-ons, the add-ons that you have in that folder should now auto-load with Blender. So that's very important. You have to get that working before anything else. So once that's done, let me minimize Blender. And now you're going to want to go and get my add-on. I'll leave a link in the description. So I have this hosted on GitHub, and you're going to click this little green button that says clone or download, and download the zip. I already have it downloaded right here. And in Blender, You would install from add-on, and I'm going to go to my desktop, and here's the add-on. You would install here. I'm going to hit cancel. I already have it installed. And the add-on should appear here, like this, or you can type debug. And when you open it, right here, it should have auto-detected the path. Otherwise, it'll say it wasn't found, and you'll unfortunately have to do it manually. Or if you forgot to install the PTVSD package, you can disable it and enable it, and it should find it. And then the first time, you might want to increase the timeout a little bit so you have a confirmation that it's attached properly. So I'm going to close that, and I'm going to go to the 3D view, and you're going to want to open up the search. The default shortcut is space. And type debug and hit start debug server for VS Code. And now if you go to window, toggle system console, just ignore all this, it shouldn't really appear there. It'll say waiting and it'll keep repeating that for 20 times. So now I'm going to open up VS Code, and this is a Blender add-on I was working on. And if you haven't already, you need to go to extensions and install the Python extension, so this one right here. And you'll probably need to reload the editor. And then after that, if you go to debug, here where it says no configurations, add a configuration, and the one you need is the one that says Python attach. And there might be others here, just delete those if you want. So that's what it should look like, and save that. And now you'll see the configuration, and then you'll want to see the debug console here. So if it's not appearing, go to view, debug console, and then hit start. Now, by now, if the confirmation was still listening, it'll tell you that the editor was attached. Probably too much time has passed by now. So if I go to, if I go to the console here, it says attach confirmation listener timed out. Now, if you want to check that anyways, if it's attached, go to the search again, type debug, and then check if VS Code is attached. So now, both in Blender and in the console in VS Code, it should say debugger is attached. So we can toggle the console off now, because everything is just outputted here. And I'm going to pin this on top of all my windows. And I'm going to add a few breakpoints. So let's add some here and here. And my add-on works in sculpt mode. So I'm going to go to sculpt mode. And I'm going to press the keyboard shortcut I have assigned to it. And here you can see Blender paused. So it's frozen. And VS Code popped up because we hit a breakpoint. So now in VS Code, if I open this up a bit, you can see all the variables, and I can step through the code. For example, here it's adding brushes for items and brushes. It's adding them to a list. So you can see the list here being created. And I could watch the index, for example. Here I'm incrementing it. And here are all the breakpoints I set. And here's the call stack. So now if I want to unfreeze Blender, I can just remove the breakpoints and hit continue. Now, if I want to make a change, for example, here it says print test. So here you can see it printed test. Now let's say print changed. So I'm going to save that. Now, Blender can't detect that I saved it. So if I were to trigger my shortcut again over here, you'll see it printed test instead of changed. So to get Blender to reload the add-on, you should have you should keep user preferences add-ons. You should keep this panel handy and then search for add-on. Mine is called useful menus, and I'm gonna disable that and then enable it again. So now it says module changed on disk. Now when I press my shortcut, it'll print changed over here. So you should never have to reload the add-on from here. You want to reload it from within Blender. So that's the basics for debugging an add-on. So now I'll show you how you can view the source code. So I'm going to disconnect and then minimize this. And say I wanted to debug the source code for this. So I right click, edit source. It tells us that it's in the text editor. So I'm going to go to the text editor. Where is it? And in this little drop down, that's the script it opened up. And what I want to know is where this is. So I'm going to hit text, save as. And here is the path where that script is stored. So I'm going to cancel. And now in VS Code, I'm going to file, open folder. And I'm going to go to that folder, hit enter, and select folder. Now, I've already done this, but VS Code, since it's not running as admin, it won't let you make any changes because it can't write to program files. So I'm going to close this and minimize Blender. And then here in VS Code, I'm going to right-click Run as Administrator. So now it has admin privileges, and suppose this VS Code setting didn't exist. So this is what it would look like if you opened it up. And now if I go to debug, if I go to add configuration, I won't get an error. So Python attach, delete the rest, save that. And I'm going to search for that background images part. And put a breakpoint, I don't know, here. And then I'm going to start the debugger, and it should... it terminated. Well, it doesn't matter. If you just disconnect it, if it terminates, just disconnect it. I'll run it again. And this time it worked, I don't know what happened. And it should attach anyways. And now when we go here, just by hovering over it, we'll have hit the breakpoint. And you can see all your variables again here, and you can debug the source code. Now, initially when I recorded this, I didn't think it was possible to edit the source code of Blender itself in an external editor and then have Blender detect that change. I just couldn't get it to work, but I eventually figured it out, and what you need to do is go to the text editor, go to View Properties, and enable live edit, and then for whatever you want to change, for example, say I want to change the cursor, you would go to edit source, the file would open, same thing I did earlier. So you need to have this file open in Blender and the same file open in your external editor. So in VS Code, I'm going to control find lock to cursor. So let's say I want to change this to say 3D cursor. So I'm going to save that, and if it gives you an error, again, that's because you have to run it as administrator. Same thing if you try to edit the code from Blender, it won't let you. You have to run Blender as an administrator. Now you might have noticed when I hovered over here to Blender, this little red button appeared here. And that means it detected a change on the disk. So we're going to click that, reload from disk. But still, I'm not seeing any changes. So what you need to do is just anywhere in the file, at the end of a line, just type a space, and you see it updated the value. So I'm not sure why it needs that little extra push, but once you do that, it'll detect the changes. And I prefer this to live editing, because live editing sometimes crashes in the middle of when you're typing something. And this, since you only save and change it in Blender once you're done making a change, it's probably less likely to crash. Anyways, if you found the video helpful, leave a like. If you have any questions, leave a comment. Otherwise, please consider subscribing. I'll be posting more Blender-related stuff in the future.